Hi, you're with Chandeep at Goodly once again, and in this video, I've got you the solution to the DAX challenge that I gave you a week ago, which is where I asked you to calculate completed refunds. Now, if you probably tried and you could not solve it, in this video, I'm going to talk about the solution, in fact, a couple of solutions in which you can approach the solution to the problem. Stay tuned, let's get started. All right, I'm in Power BI, the data has been loaded. Let me just take 2 minutes to quickly recap the problem and then discuss possible frameworks of building a solution. And then we'll go ahead and build the solution together. So we had this particular data model. And in this data model, if you take a look, we have two standard lookup tables, calendar and the products. On the many side, it's been linked to sales. And the sales on the one side has been linked on the many side to the refunds table. Now, the logic is that every transaction has a unique transaction ID. So if you take a look at the sales table here, every single transaction has a unique transaction ID, but one single transaction of the sales could be refunded multiple number of times. So this sales transaction, for instance, sold 4 units, but the customer can refund this particular transaction at multiple instances till the time the total of all the refunds reaches 4 units, all the units that have been purchased. So that was the logic. So if you now take a look at the refunds table, I'm going to find that in the refunds table, the transaction ID is duplicated. Consider this transaction for a moment. So let's just say 226J11. You will find that there were 2 instances of this particular transaction ID, 2 instances of the refunds, and both of them are not complete. So one of them is complete and the other one is not complete. The job was to calculate the refund amount only if both the instances or all the instances of any particular transaction ID are marked as complete. Let me give you an example. So if you take a look at this particular transaction, 370011, you will find that both the instances of this particular transaction are complete, and that's where you had to calculate the refunds for this one. All right, before we start to write some sophisticated DAX to be able to solve this problem, I want to give you a fundamental framework of conceptually understanding the problem first and then doing something to be able to solve this problem easily. To be able to do that, what I have done is I have actually filtered out this particular refunds table to just one transaction ID. And I can see that I have left over with 2 rows or 2 instances of the refund that happened. Now, once we take a look at what do we have to do with one transaction ID, that's the same thing that we have to do row by row for all the transaction IDs. So take a look. Once I have got the data for this transaction ID, I have to then take a look at every single row here and make sure that all the instances are marked as complete. If they are all marked as complete, I will calculate the refund amount. If they are not, I will not do that. So if you think about it, I have to first find out all the transaction IDs first, that how many transactions IDs are there in the first place in the refunds table. So let's just hypothetically say that there are 3 transaction IDs. For the first transaction ID, I pick up that ID, I apply a filter on this particular table, and then I see all the records or all the instances of the refunds. If all of them are marked complete, I calculate the refund amount for that. If they're not complete, I do not calculate. And similarly, I have to do this nested iteration for all the transaction IDs present in the refunds table. Now, in order for me to make the process really, really simple, I would rather play a data modeling trick and not try to solve this using explicitly a DAX measure, although you can do that, but I would try to play a data modeling trick and make the problem easier for me to solve rather than actually struggling with DAX. Let's just actually find a way to be able to do that using Power Query first, and then we'll come at a DAX data modeling approach. All right, I'm in Power Query, and that's where you can see that the data has been loaded. Let me just try to transform the data and try to work with the data to be able to solve the problem. What I'm trying to do is, for every single transaction, I'm trying to mark that transaction. Are all the instances of the refunds complete or not complete? If they are complete, give me a true. If they are not complete, give me a false. As simple as that. So let's just see what can we do. Now, for the obvious reason that because the transaction ID is duplicated, the next step obviously that I'm going to do is group the rows, and you can see that I have grouped the rows, which is where I am now left with a unique transaction ID and a table that shows me all the data of the transaction ID. In case the transaction ID has got multiple rows, you can see that the preview of the table does show me multiple rows of data for that particular transaction ID. Now, The logic that I'm trying to build is simple. I'm just trying to say that for the transaction ID selected, please take a look at this entire column, which is the refund status. Make sure that all the instances of the refunds are complete. Now, to be able to do that, I have already written a very simple piece of M code that I'm going to add it as a column. I'm just going to add a column right here. What this column calculation is going to do is it's going to pick up this particular table. From this table, it's going to pick up this particular column. And in this column, it's going to make sure that all the items are marked as complete. And if they are complete, the label that you're going to see in this value is nothing but true. That's what I'm trying to do. So to be able to do that, I'm just going to add one more calculation. So you can see that as of now, all data is nothing but the entire table as it is. But I'm just going to add one more calculation here. I'm just going to put a comma and just copy paste the M code that I have already created. I'm just going to press enter. What this is going to do is it's going to create a completed transaction check and mark all the transaction as complete or not complete. Now, you can see that this refunds table is still unique as of now. There is unique transaction ID, but I do want the data in the same shape as it was loaded, but just with one extra column. So I expand this particular all data, and I'll make sure that I extract again the refund date, the units refunded, and the completed transaction status. The transaction ID is something that I already have, which I will not extract. So I will expand it, change the type. I have got this additional column, and I will load this data back into Power BI. All right, once the data has been loaded, you can take a look. We have this particular column which marks that all the refund instances are complete or not. That's true. We can also do a little test. So let's just go take a look at that particular transaction ID, 226J11. You're going to find that not all the instances were complete and hence you have a false. Let me also take a look at another transaction ID that I remember, which is this one, where all the instances were complete and they were actually marked as true. Now, I can go ahead and write a ridiculously simple measure, and my measure is going to look something like this. So I'm going to say that, hey, go in every single row of the refunds table, pick up the units, multiply that with the price from the VLOOKUP of the price, and then just make sure that this check is also there, that you've just picking up the true values from there. Now, this measure might just give you the right answer, but there is a one simple quirk in this measure, I can so call it. And that quirk is that as of now, if you take a look at the calendar table, which is where the year and the month dimensions have been pulled, is linked to my sales using the sales date. And here the transaction ID is linked with the transaction ID. That means that we are now taking a look at those transaction IDs which were refunded that were sold, not necessarily refunded in the same month. If I'm taking a look at the calendar and if I'm wanting to find the refunds in the same month, I also have to build a secondary relationship with the calendar date and the refund date right here, which is obviously going to be inactive, and I have to activate that relationship using the use relationship function. So how do I do that? Although the results are not going to change because the units sold are also the units refunded in the same month, but in case that waivers for any particular month, you're going to see different answers for here. So for now, I'm just going to come here and say that, hey, please do not use the standard calendar to sales to refunds relationship. Please use this relationship, which is the calendar date and the refunds date. That's the relationship that you should use. And now this measure is absolutely foolproof, and this gives me the right result. All right, the second approach that I'm going to talk about is by using DAX and by creating a calculator table. Now, if for some reason you don't have access to Power Query and you're not allowed to alter how the data has been loaded, you can also follow this particular approach, and that will also make the process of creating this calculation a lot more easier. The first thing that I have done is I have created the simple one columnar table, which is where I'm saying, hey, why don't you go to the refunds table, get all the unique transaction IDs from the refunds table. And that's what this formula does. All no blank row, no blanks, but all the unique transaction IDs from the refunds table. Now, once I get all the unique transaction IDs, I create the simple check column. And in this check column, what I'm trying to do is find that are all the instances of any particular refund are marked as complete or not. Simple as that. So I create the simple check. In this check, first of all, count the number of rows that are there against any particular transaction ID. So for this particular transaction ID, how many rows are there in the refunds table? That's my first thing. Then I find out that how many rows are marked as complete. So this is the total number of rows, this is the number of rows that are marked as complete. And if both are same, the total number of rows and the completed number of rows are the same, that means all the rows have been marked as complete. As simple as that. Now, as of now, it's showing you a false all across because there is no relationship built between the two tables. And once I build the relationship, you're going to see that a bunch of transaction IDs are marked as complete. So let's just do that. In the modeling tab, transaction ID gets linked with the transaction ID right here. And this check column that we have created should start to reflect the correct data. So if you take a look that this particular transaction ID is complete, this one is complete, this one is complete, so on and so forth. Now I go back to my measure right here, and in the measure right here, I can not call the Power Query column. Instead, I can call this particular column, which is my completed refunds, the one that I have created. Check should be equal to true. That's what I can say. And this also is going to get the job done with a use relationship between the two tables. And this is also going to get the work done. All right, this is working just fine. All right, those were my two solutions. And here's a quick tip that I'd like to give it to you. In case you have an option of pre-calculating anything at the data level or at Power Query level, I personally almost always I'm going to pick up that particular option rather than actually making my DAX very, very complicated. But in case you are interested to take a look at how do you solve this particular problem using a measure only approach, I suggest you that you take a look at the blog comments. There are a lot of people who have come up with ingenious ways of solving this particular problem using a measure only approach. And in case you were also the one who participated in this particular problem, I give you a big shout out to everybody who participated. Thanks so much for spending out your time on this. In the end, a quick shout out about my DAX and my Power Query courses. In case you're starting out with Power BI and learning DAX and Power Query seem hard and you'd like to start with fundamentals first and then proceed on to solving more challenging, more sophisticated problems of your data, I'd highly recommend that you take a look at my courses. It's going to be highly beneficial. Thanks so much for spending time with me once again, and I will catch you guys in the next one. Cheers. Bye.